Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and in this video we're going to be going over the changes and updates coming to Scholar and Final Fantasy XIV's next expansion, Shadowbringers. This information is coming to you from the North American media tour that I attended last week. Keep in mind though, all of these things are still subject to change. It could be potencies, effects, whatever, it could change by the time we get Shadowbringers in late June / early July. So with that, we'll throw a watermark at the bottom to remind you as you're listening, and let's get started. Now, Scholar's identity remains mostly intact. It still has its shielding, it still has a lot of the old skills that it had before, but it's also been given a little bit more focus on the pet and enhancing the skills that you already have. So let's start off with the abilities that are mostly similar to the way they were before. Physic, Resurrection, Ruin, Bio, Ruin 2, Lustrate, Indom, Broil, Emergency Tactics, Deployment Tactics, Dissipation, XCOG, Change Stratagem, and Aether Pact are all roughly the same. Despite that, there actually is a pretty long list of removed skills as well, which just makes me just wow at how many skills there were for Scholar. Miasma and Miasma 2 are both gone, Energy Drain, Sustain is no longer needed with the pet changes, Bane, Rouse, Shadow Flare, Fey Covenant, Silent Dusk, Fey Caress, Fey Wind, and Enhanced Mind are all gone. Moving on to the skills that were adjusted, it's important to first note that just like with Summoner, pets underwent a change going into Shadowbringers. Now, they can no longer be targeted by players or enemies in combat. For Summoners, this meant that the pet had more survivability and Titan was going to need a rework. For Scholars, my first thought was not the fairy's safety, but the fact that I can no longer deploy an Adlo off the fairy as a safe target. So if you're used to doing that, keep in mind you're going to be deploying your Adlos off of players. Speaking of pets, Eos and Selene underwent a pretty major change as well. They both have the exact same abilities and effects now, so the only thing you have to choose between is which one looks cooler. It's kind of weird, but I mean, I guess it levels them out. Also, Eos and Selene's main actions other than Embrace are no longer on their pet hotbar. You now have to control them manually as the player, and because they're the same skills, they don't take up a ton of different action bar spaces. Whispering Dawn is still the same, and that's just going to be the regen, 21 second duration. Fey Illumination combined some of the previous fairy effects you had, and not only reduces the magic damage taken by the party by 5%, but also increases the healing they receive by 10% for 20 seconds. Now we will talk about this a bit later, but you do have a new fairy named Seraph, and both of these skills will turn into Seraphic versions when Seraph is around. But the effects and potencies are exactly the same. It's just so that way you don't have to worry about putting additional skills on your action bar. Now this change actually took me a couple of times to notice, but you can no longer use Aether Flow outside of combat. You can only use it once the fight actually starts. I'm assuming that's so people don't wait on really long openers or just so you can get the cooldown back again before the fight actually starts, but it does mean you gotta remember it at the start of every fight now. Eloquium underwent a pretty interesting change as well. So the core concept is the same, but the way that the buffs actually work to determine the shield are quite different. Eloquium's base shield is now 125% of the HP restored instead of the flat 100%. And now instead of galvanizing doubling in strength when you land a critical hit with Eloquium, crits now additionally grant a new buff called Catalyze, which grants another shield equal to the heal received. From what I can tell, other shields, like the ones that come from Astro, they simply cannot overwrite Galvanize, which means if you get a crit Adlo, but you have an Astro that happens to put on a shield that's stronger at base, it can overwrite the Galvanize, but it can't overwrite the Catalyze. I guess it's just to separate them so that way they don't interact quite as harshly as they did before, but it was still a pretty weird change. Sucker also got a little bit of a buff. It went from 125% of the HP restored on the shield to 150%, so even more additional AoE shielding. And the final skill that saw a change from Scholar's old kit is Sacred Soil. After it gets to level 78, it earns a trait that gives everyone inside of the Sacred Soil a regen. Now, my White Mage video, we went over Asylum granting increased healing received. I feel like maybe at least before we get into endgame content, if I were to look at Sacred Soil and Asylum side by side, I'd probably still take Sacred Soil. Now, Scholar did get a handful of new skills, some of them just evolved from old versions and some of them brand new. Art of War is their new AoE spamming ability for dungeons or for large AoE packs. Because Miasma 2 is gone, they needed something. Art of War is just 150 AoE potency around the Scholar. It's kind of underwhelming and it felt like it was very MP intensive. Bio and Broil 2 do also evolve once you get a trait at level 72. Bio becomes Biolysis and Broil 2 becomes Broil 3. More damage, higher level, Can't complain. The next skill is one that scholars have been asking for 6 years. Recitation removes the resource cost from your next Adlo, Sucker, Indom, or Xcog. Now for Adlo and Sucker, obviously that's removing the MP cost, and for Indom and Xcog, it removes the cost of an Aether Flow. However, the bigger effect is that it also ensures that whichever spell you cast of the four will restore critical HP. Yes, that means you can force a crit deployment. Oh my goodness, I am excited. However, I can see the merits for using it on certain other skills, and it sits on a fairly reasonable cooldown of 90 seconds. Now, one of my big complaints about the Fey Gauge in Stormblood was that it only worked on the Tether, so they decided to give Scholars another use for it. Fey Blessing is a skill you'll learn close to max level, which consumes 10 Fairy Gauge to tell Eos or Selene to perform an AoE heal. When you get to max level on Scholar, you'll actually pick up two skills instead of one. The first one is Summon Seraph, which will replace whichever fairy you have with Seraph, a much more powerful fairy, for 20 seconds. Embrace becomes Seraphic Veil, which provides a mini Galvanize equal to the heal that Seraph does, so she'll be just slinging out shields for the entire duration. On top of that, you'll also earn Consolation, which charges up to 2. Now that will be an AoE heal plus shield coming from Seraph as well, so you have a lot more shielding and healing capabilities between Fey Blessing, Seraph, and Consolation. However, that's it for Scholar's new skills. They also got, you know, some new traits. A lot of the old ones stayed the same. The lower level Corruption and Broil Masteries, Maim and Mend. Corruption Mastery 2, increasing Bio to Biolysis. Broil Mastery, changing Broil 2 to 3. It does also increase Ruin 2's potency up to 200 as well. And then Enhanced Sacred Soil we mentioned earlier, which will cause Sacred Soil to give that regen effect when people are standing in it. Now, in case you haven't seen my other healer videos yet, I personally felt that at least while running the dungeon, in which case, by the way, is capped at a pretty low level, so it doesn't really give me the opportunity to try Scholar at level 80, it feels like it'll still be really great in raids, but it didn't feel good in dungeons. Only having the one AoE skill in that of Art of War, not having a Shadow Flare, not having a Bane, it just didn't feel right, I guess if that makes sense. On bosses, it feels great. I feel like now more than ever, my fairy is a larger portion of my power, which I think is a good thing, but it just didn't feel complete, if you know what I mean. I'm looking forward to more experienced scholars giving me their thoughts on it, because obviously you're asking someone who isn't all too, I guess, invested in this job. I really haven't enjoyed it much over the years. That being said, let me know what you thought about the updates and changes to Scholars. Quick shout out to the fellow members of the Final Fantasy XIV content creator community. You're probably tired of hearing me say this if you've been watching through all my videos, but I was missing a bunch of traits and hoveroversfor certain things throughout these various videos, and a reminder that there are plenty of other people creating content out of this media tour, and that they have assisted me and we've been assisting each other with various things like tooltips and whatnot, bouncing ideas off each other, etc., etc. So big shout out to them. Be sure to go check out some of the other videos being made for the media tour, as well as my other videos as well. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and be sure to check out all those other videos. That's a lot of videos. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the next one, and until then, take care.